Every year in January, this is the scene down in Tifton as cotton producers from all over the state gather together for the Georgia Cotton Commission's annual meeting. However, that was not the case this year, as the commission made the decision to hold the meeting virtually due to COVID-19, the way they felt they could keep their growers safe and still get important information out to them.
The Georgia Cotton Commission's annual meeting, we've been doing it for approximately 15 years, and it's just an event to gather the cotton industry as a whole here in the state and to update growers and other interested people on what's going on in the cotton industry. So much of what affects our producers is things that goes on beyond the farm. So updates on regulatory issues or updates from Washington, updates from the Extension Service, things like that are very important to the success of our farmers.
That's especially true after a year like 2020, in which cotton took a big hit as market prices plummeted due to the pandemic.
We started out the year with probably the best start that we'd ever had, and the pandemic hit, and cotton, probably more so than most commodities, took a pretty astronomical hit from the pandemic from a market perspective. Futures got as low as, you know, down below 50 cent, and that's, you know, obviously problematic for our producers.
Coming off a year like 2020 is one reason why the commission thought it was important to have a discussion on a very detrimental pest that, in the past, was 25% of producers' production cost, and that was the boll weevil.
When we had boll weevils in the state of Georgia, it wasn't uncommon for individual growers to spray a field of cotton upwards of 20 times in a season. You know, that's a big change to where we are today. But the first boll weevil was found in the state of Georgia in 1915. And believe it or not, at that time, there were over 5 million acres of cotton in Georgia. The boll weevil basically devastated the cotton industry, and we saw a reduction in acres down to not much over 100,000 acres in the mid-80s.
Thankfully, here in Georgia, the boll weevil was eradicated back in the 80s and was last seen almost 20 years ago. But the important thing they want producers to know is that just because it was eradicated doesn't mean it can't come back, which could be devastating to Georgia's cotton industry if it did.
We have not found a boll weevil in Georgia since 2002. Would it be a threat here if it were to be introduced? I can tell you this, that in the lower Rio Grande Valley of Texas, where they're trying to actively eradicate the boll weevil, they produce a maximum of about 200,000 acres of cotton a year. That program sprayed 1.297 million acres last year trying to control the boll weevil. Yes, if the boll weevil came here, it would have a very detrimental effect on our production.
Reporting in Tift County for the Farm Monitor, I'm John Holcomb.